Dearest reader, follow me as we step into the world of Bridgerton and uncover the enigma that is Miss Penelope Featherington. Penelope is, in my opinion, the most complex character in Bridgerton. Her character arc extends far beyond the scope of the show. She's not just a girl who wants to spread gossip, but an individual who mocks the monarchy. Lady Whistledown is more than just a Gossip Girl copy. Let me show you why. For those who are unfamiliar, Penelope is the youngest daughter of Lord and Lady Featherington. Pen has two older sisters, Philippa and Prudence. The Featherington family is a prominent but often mocked and socially less respected family in upper-class London society. Penelope is close friends with her neighbor Eloise, and she has a deep infatuation with Colin Bridgerton, but she lacks the confidence to reveal her feelings.
Also, lonely, perhaps.
Well, I was never on my own, of course.
I see. Pen, you met someone.
Pen, I finally found you.
You always do.
Pen also has an alter ego as Lady Whistledown, which is a gossip column that she publishes anonymously. It is for this reason that I think she stands out in the Bridgerton world. She's not the first to write a scandal sheet, but she's the only one to gain immense popularity. There's a duality in Pen. She's both sweet, timid, and insecure, but also cunning, manipulative, and driven by self-interest. In order to understand Penn's divisive nature, I think we have to take a look at why she's so problematic in the Bridgerton world. The greatest problem with Penelope lies in her work as Lady Whistledown. Lady Whistledown is a gossip column, and gossiping is not seen as a noble art, nor should it be. Gossip can have lasting effects that reverberate long after the words are written. These columns seek primarily to entertain at the expense of others. Eloise makes a fair point to Penn that Lady Whistledown's focus rarely extends beyond the superficiality of the marriage season. Penn's skills as a writer could be channeled into a more noble endeavor. And one of the controversial ways in which she uses Lady Whistledown is to attack her family. In the opening scene of season one, she introduces her mom by calling her tasteless and tactless. This goes beyond mere gossip. She feels like she can't say these things out loud, and so she writes them. And I'm okay with it. At 17 years old, I would expect her to be thankless and critical of her family. She often finds herself relegated to the role of the overlooked sibling. Both her mother and sisters frequently belittle her.
This mama.
What she is two stone heavier than she ought to be.
Those blemishes on her face are quite difficult to conceal.
Or perhaps some arsenic and lead might help.
Do not forget to bid Prudence, Philippa, or even Penelope farewell as you go.
Another criticism of Penelope is her financial position. Her family is struggling financially and Pen has the money. Pen doesn't know about the money troubles in the first season, but in the second season we see Lady Featherington selling household items to keep her family afloat. We don't actually know how much money Penelope has and whether this money would be enough to sustain her family, but what we do know is that she's been running her business for about two marriage seasons. The demand for her work among the elite suggests a steady stream of income. In addition, Pen is a problematic friend. She doesn't tell her best friend, Eloise, that she is Lady Whistledown. From the outset, the show makes it clear that the two are very close. It's also clear from the beginning that Eloise is invested in Lady Whistledown. She both criticizes and respects her. Eloise talks to Pen about Lady Whistledown many times. This is a break of trust on multiple levels. Pen has her reasons to keep her identity hidden, but it doesn't diminish the pain and betrayal of keeping such a secret.
I wish never to see or speak to you again.
The biggest critiques with Penelope often come down to two decisions that she made as Lady Whistledown. The first moment happens in season one when Pen, as Lady Whistledown, reveals Marina's pregnancy to the public. For context, Marina came to London already pregnant and tried to marry as quickly as possible under the pressure of Lady Featherington. Unfortunately, Colin Bridgerton became the victim of this scheme. Pen tried to convince Marina not to marry Colin. After Marina refused, Penelope made the decision to write about Marina's pregnancy in the Lady Whistledown column. By doing this, she damaged the reputation of her family and put Marina's livelihood at risk. I know that many people have made arguments defending this particular decision, and one of the arguments is that Pen was truly trying to protect her friend Colin from being lied to and deceived by Marina. And I do think there is some element of that sentiment in her decision-making process. However, this argument doesn't resolve all the other options that Pen had in that particular situation. She could have done this privately. I think the best option would have been to tell Colin directly. That way, it would have been his decision to make. Alternatively, she could have told Eloise and asked for her advice. She could have even told Violet Bridgerton, the matriarch of the family, who probably has more experience in dealing with scandalous scenarios. She could have written an anonymous letter to Colin instead. In all of those scenarios, she would have still been protecting Colin, while at the same time preserving her family's reputation and not jeopardizing Marina's future.
I shall take my leave of you for the last time, Miss Thompson.
The second moment of contention happens in season 2 when Penelope, as Lady Whistledown, writes that Eloise, her best friend, has been consorting with political radicals. For context, the Queen accused Eloise of being Lady Whistledown because one of the Queen's footmen saw Eloise sneaking off to a printer shop. In order to make the Queen realize that Eloise is not Lady Whistledown, Penelope decided to write something damaging about Eloise in her column. By doing this, Penn put Eloise's reputation in jeopardy. Much like the first decision, there's an argument that Penn was trying to protect Eloise. But Penn had other options. The best option, in my opinion, was to tell Eloise the truth. Together, they could have come up with a solution. Penelope, as herself and as Lady Whistledown, is a big player on the show. We can see that most clearly in the fact that she's the narrator. She drives the plot forward. Lady Whistledown's influence on the town is undeniable. The upper class spend their time talking about her. Penn holds a unique power to shape conversations and dictate social narratives. When Penn stops writing as Lady Whistledown towards the end of season 2, we see the public up in arms.
It's been a week since she last published.
There should have been at least 2 issues by now, if not 3.
You there. What have you done with our scandal sheet?
Nothing today, sir. Would you like a newspaper?
Nonsense.
It's interesting that Penn had no credibility as Lady Whistledown, yet, from the very first issue, everyone cared what she had to say. I know that Lady Whistledown stands out because she actually mentioned people by name, but that still doesn't explain why people are trusting her so much. Penelope carved out her own path in a world that sought to confine her. Her power knows no bounds. We learn just as much about her, and maybe even more, than some of the Bridgertons. She gets a lot of character development. We learn about her motivations, her feelings, who she's close with, what she likes, what she hates. We learn about her personality. Penn is not an evil person. Penn feels the consequences of her actions. That's what's so satisfying to watch. We see that her actions impact her emotionally. Her own consciousness punishes her. After Penelope revealed Marina's pregnancy to the public, we see Penn sobbing and breaking down in front of Eloise. Her own consciousness doesn't let her come off unscathed. Penelope has a similar reaction after she writes that Eloise is consorting with political radicals. Penn decided to quit writing because of what she has done. She recognized that what she was doing was causing more harm than good. As Penn described it, she had only one thing in life going for her, and she quit it for Eloise.
Whistledown has been all I have had, and I have given it up. I am done with it. I wrote what I wrote, and I gave it up for you.
We also see throughout the show that Penelope cares about people. She's not a sociopath. Her relationship with Eloise is real. She loves Eloise, and the fact that they have a close relationship shows that Penelope is the kind of person that can develop deep bonds. She was the first to become friends with Marina. Of course, Penn's initial curiosity about Marina came from her interest to investigate Marina's pregnancy. But then she genuinely became invested in Marina's happiness and Marina's relationship with George. Penn eagerly waited for George's letters. She also tried to save Marina from Lady Featherington's matchmaking schemes. When Penn tried to bring down the relationship between Marina and Colin, she tells Colin that Marina loves someone else, not that she's pregnant. It was only after a negative conversation with Marina that Penn made the decision to print the truth. Penelope steps into the role of a negotiator so seamlessly, it's almost scary. She goes to the printer shop disguised as a maid and transforms into a different person. This is not the Penelope we met before.
That doesn't make you special, Mr. Harris. Printers in this town are 10 a penny. But there's only one Lady Whistledown, and she could just as easily take her business elsewhere. So it's 18.
At just 17 years old, she accomplished what seemed nearly impossible for a woman of her time. She established a business that became successful in less than a year. In an era where women were discouraged from pursuing knowledge and skills outside the domestic sphere, Penn defied expectations. She used her talents to deliver to the public what they want. Penelope knows how to negotiate and knows how to work the system. She's incredibly resourceful. She figured out how to find a publisher and how to convince the publisher to print her work by pretending to be a worker.
100 copies, 5 pence a piece, sold for 8 pence each, minus the delivery boy's wages, it should be £11, 2 shillings here altogether. My mistress is willing to take an even 10. You get to keep the surplus of your appetite.
It's also notable that Penelope doesn't need to work. She's not driven to her business out of necessity. Sure, there are other women in the society that work, but she's the only one depicted on the show who has a trade by choice. Even Eloise, who criticizes Lady Whistledown, can't help but admire what she does. The most intriguing aspect of Penelope's character is her criticism of the crown. She manages to capture the attention of the queen and calls her out. In the very first episode, she wrote, "For we all must know what the queen despises more than anything, being wrong. So here we are with the strongest, most powerful person in England being threatened by a 17-year-old girl. I think that's remarkable." And Penelope's astutely aware of the fact that she's playing the queen. At Edwina and Anthony's wedding, she perceptively points out that perhaps the queen is going for this opulence for the wedding in order to prove herself.
Perhaps the queen requires our attention in new ways. Weight of the crown is quite heavy. Perhaps she seeks to prove herself still significant and equal to the task.
It's interesting that the first issue of Lady Whistledown came out on the day that Pen is presented to society. It's as if her trepidations about the event drove her to create this alter ego. A part of me wonders if Lady Whistledown came out as a self-defense mechanism and a defense against the queen. Because it seems like Penelope sees the queen as an antagonist. When she comes to Lady Delacroix for help in saving Eloise, Pen asks Lady Delacroix if she has heard any praise about the queen so that Pen can publish it. It's funny that Penelope has nothing nice to say about the queen herself. It sort of suggests that a portion of her column serves as an attack on the monarchy. I don't know if Pen's critique is genius or stupidity, but I have to admire the boldness. I think that Penelope's column as Lady Whistledown is really a reflection of what's happening in society in this point in time. By writing this column, I think she's not only spreading gossip, but giving the public a reflection back as to what they look like. Yes, Penelope focuses on trivial matters, but she also reveals the distorted values and superficial preoccupations that permeate their lives. Within this society, there's an obsession with shallow aspects of a person's character, such as their reputation, their title, or skills such as needlework that really have nothing to do with the person's value. Women are treated like chattel and exchanged like property. It's a society that, in many ways, becomes a mockery of itself. It's also worth noting that Penelope's column exclusively focuses on the elite, the upper class. Her attacks are not on the masses. In addition, Penelope is sort of like a puppeteer, manipulating the threads of the marriage market. In this world, the marriage market matters. It's a calculated business decision. And in this realm, Lady Whistledown influences the market. Penn's column also holds a political undertone. She provokes the queen and openly criticizes her. This is a direct affront to established order. By writing about the marriage season, Penn is undermining it. She possesses the potential to make a broader impact. People listen to her and may listen to her if she decides to bring down the institution or the monarchy.
Your move, Your Majesty.
I think Eloise recognizes this too. In the first season, when the queen states that she will take down Lady Whistledown, Eloise defends her, saying, "You wish to silence her? But there's so much good that she must do." Eloise is aware that Penn's writings hold the power to effect positive change.
I am certain you will find your purpose one day. Everyone must eventually.
Have you found yours?
Of course not. But I imagine it to be something both animated and satisfying. The type of entity that speaks not to who I am, but rather who I aim to be. My purpose will challenge me to be brave and witty. My purpose will propel me far beyond the watchful glare of my mama. My purpose, she'll set me free.
What could possibly measure up to all that?
Penelope is a flawed character living in a flawed society. Some people may despise Penelope for her actions, and I understand why, but I embrace them. I want my characters to be flawed. Characters can be deeply flawed as long as they're interesting. I'm not here to justify Penelope's actions. Her actions are sometimes hard to justify, but I do think she's a product of her environment. We can see that Penn's mother has the natural skill for conspiring and using ruthless tactics to preserve her family. In this world, women learn that their power lies in their ability to talk and gossip. This spectacle of a society already exists without Lady Whistledown. She didn't create it. She's just adding fuel to the fire. So let's let her take this dumpster fire of our society and burn it to the ground.